Hello everyone, and welcome back to Dead Space. This is, kind of exciting. We're now on the surface of the planet.
Use one of the loaders to get the marker off the shuttle.
Loaders? Oh, yes. Well, at least I'm glad that we, filled up the, what are those noises? And what is this? This isn't the Ishimura anymore, right? This is, just the thing. And now, hold on, I'm trying to think through all the stuff we've been through. We're here to try and deal with the hive mind. Oh, is this the planet crack? Oh, that's real cool! Man, that's really awesome. Piece of rock that's been excavated. Gigantic hole. What was I saying? Right, there's like a giant monster that Kine showed me. And I have to, try to put back the marker because that silences it or something, or it will help it. I'm trying to make it whole again. Which I don't totally trust. And so if we're not in the Ishimura, then what about the, I remember there being the creature noises. There is that giant mass still on there, right? Is this important? Should we be fixing that? Can I interact with you in any way? No. Excellent. At least you're giving me some ammo. I know what to drop, though. Definitely the flame ammo. Those noises are creepy, even though they sound like they could just be, they could just be...
Isaac, the marker needs to be returned to the pedestal chamber. Use the loader to bring it there and place it on the pedestal. Replace what was taken. Again.
Uh-huh. You're getting away from that. I know what that is. So is the story here that they contained it over there, but something killed them all anyway? Oh wait, hold on. Are these, oh no, what? The same thing happened here? They also have their heads poked in. Why do these take so many shots? Was I also just missing? Yeah, no. Voice is bad. Oh, is the power thing that I need? Okay. I got it. Cool. And the save station, why not? More saving the better. I am actually playing these last, this is... I did not stop after the last episode, just cause, may Altman be within you. Chapel services twice weekly. Does he have rabbit ears? Such as backdrop. I like the implication that literally the exact same thing happened here. Dear God, keep us safe from monsters. I can't read that. There is no way out. Can't see that. I wish I could read more of those. But a combination of exhaustion and the font and the texture resolution is conspiring to make that not happen. Oh, sure.
This is Sergeant Newman, PSEC. We've lost all the shuttles. One of them just took off and came straight back down and crashed into the bay. Took a couple of hundred people and all the remaining shuttles with it. If anyone can hear this, do not land. Do not land.
Do not land? Well, we did. Guys just hung up from everywhere. Their heads smashed in. I do wonder if they use people somehow. Whatever the infection is. Oh, hey, there's a store right here. I guess we don't need to buy ammo. Because we have so much of it. But I am going to attempt to sell this anyway. I think I have more than enough plasma energy. So I'm going to go ahead and stash a couple of those. That's 100 shots. That's more than enough. Plus the 20 that I have, plus some that we'll inevitably find. And also all this crap. Like, I don't know that I will go through more than this immediately. So definitely make room in the form of some of these stasis packs. 3 is probably more than enough. I don't know if we'll need the air can for anything, but I'm keeping it just in case. It's not really... by the time you need the large med packs, it's too dang late anyway. And that's a lot of... I'm tempted to get power nodes. I know that there is a new game plus. I don't know what carries over though, so I don't know if I should keep this, sell it all, and just, you know, go for it. Or, you know, just, like, sell everything and then buy ammo. Or what? So, I'm gonna keep playing along for now. Because I honestly don't know what else I'd be doing with the stuff at this point. I've made some decisions. I'm gonna save again. I'm just gonna save over the previous one. No sense in keeping multiple ones around. Strategy is to cut the legs off so that it collapses. Is that it? No, that's just the wind. Did not like that sound. What is that sound that they make? It echoes everywhere. Okay. I get it, kind of. Where'd she go? Natalie, go. Is that it? It's just emerging. So there is a government conspiracy. They did cover it up. The religion's just, it really is the distortion of what's going on. So I called it, and I feel good about that one, because it's more of a, like, I called it because it makes sense, unless I called it because it's obvious, which is fine by me. Okay, so I just did a puzzle, slightly out of order. Please tell me that doesn't kill me. Okay. At least it doesn't just kill me. side, maybe? Ah! I earned that one. That's totally my own fault. I earned that one. No, shutter controls are offline. I can't extract it anymore. Oh, okay. See, that's not obvious. I guess it still has the thing on it, but I figured that something was meaningful about that. You know, I wonder if this has a, like, why these shutters, right? They're really big, and I remember seeing this, as I mentioned before, I watched this 4-star playthrough. And I didn't remember that twist, so like I mentioned as well, I don't necessarily remember what happened. I do remember some of this section, just escorting the marker. Just cause it was, I don't know, interesting, it fit my expectations of this game. Why is everything so noisy and loud? Where are they? Somewhat intense. Does my only criticism here though, oh, I guess it should have stasis things maybe? That might have helped. It suffers from the same feeling of just like, they're just throwing crap at me over and over. I think I do still kind of don't understand is why. Like, make us whole again makes it pretty clear there's something that wants us to put the marker back. I guess I should pretty freely use stasis then. If it's not clear, then it's a different thing from the... It's some different thing from the... The necromorph? What am I... What is that? That was a waste of time. Alright, where do you gotta go? To the end, I guess? That's just parts, okay. Okay. guess the trick is you have to shoot near their bodies. So now what? Can't go there. That opens this up. Oh. I can't open that door, but I guess now I am ready for when I can. Semiconductor. There's so much stuff that they just want me to sell. It's a little weird. Where are the chance coming from? That's my question. Oh, it was on that side. Oh, damn it. Well. Wait for these, because I can use them against the others. They're kind of the least threatening in a way. Like, they're all bad if they get close. They're just also useful at a distance against their friends. Ah, and now I finally get to figure out what it is that I unlocked. Probably ammo, to be honest. I guess I'm glad I didn't spend those power nodes. Maybe I should have bought more power nodes. I kind of forgot that you could use them this way too. That's a lot of plasma energy, I'm not gonna lie. I would much rather fill myself with plasma energy. What is it thinking I want to pick up? Okay. That one, and that one. Okay, whatever. You know, I'm not gonna carry around stuff. I'm not gonna carry around ammo just to sell it anymore. I'm okay with carrying around the ruby thing, because that's it exists to be sold, and it's only one item, and it's high value. The ammo is so, like, so barely worth selling. I'm not gonna go along with it anymore. Oh, so that was also something I wanted to mention. Because we have this sectioning stuff, right? I'm thinking it's technically driven, right? Because as soon as they close that thing, it means that they don't have to, they can get rid of all the outdoors, like, they can unload it. They can go away.
Isaac, you're almost there. You'll have to restore power to the bridges to move the marker through this area. Look for a control station at the end of the maintenance tube.
Like, it's not just the, like, it's not just, oh, a new thing has appeared that drives it. It's actually, like, you just look at an enemy, and this might be creepy, so here's a music cue to go with it. Yeah? Okay. It's a nice touch. Makes what might otherwise be a very plain thing into to a very interesting, like, it's unnerving on its own to just have that music play anytime an enemy is around, because it makes it feel like it's a new enemy and that you're missing something. It's that uncertainty, at least for me, that causes a lot of, oh, this is the shop. I wanted to sell that. Which is a free power node, if you think about it. I don't need that right now. Probably stand one less of those. Yeah. I'm gonna keep saving up the credits until we see another power node or whatever, and I hope we can get back here. So I can't move the bridges. I'm gonna raid the place before I get too far along. There's a lot of stasis. I guess they're trying to encourage me. Like, that is, I guess, the only reasonable way to fight lots of enemies at once in this game, is you slow down a few of them, and then take out the ones that you can. I appreciate the save station quite a bit, though. Nice touch. Oh, okay. Nothing there. Does this open? That's also just the other side. Yeah, okay. Is that an arrow? Yes. What does it say? This way. Clever. It fits. And it is the right thing. Alright, well, the only thing to do is go in here. So, yeah, I guess I didn't even really need Natalie to tell me what's up, because I don't really have an option. Where are there people bits everywhere? Oh, this is cool! Like, this is a good use of walking on the walls. It feels unique, even if it doesn't. And then they just made it terrifying. Now this thing can also walk on the walls. Be anywhere. Got it? Why did they take... I must be missing. Is that backwards? No, just more people bits. Let's pick that up. Hi, you. You're kind of the least threatening, actually. Because the way you react. Okay. Did you drop anything? Is that it? That looks like a drop. Yes. That's why there are people bits everywhere. I do really like the way that the get back here. The way the zero G stuff kind of changes the way you think about the environments, right? Because now everything might be a surface you can use. It's unfortunate that it isn't, but I understand what it is. Again, bringing up the portal analogy. You don't really want to let the player go everywhere, because then they can screw themselves, and it's really, really difficult to design a space so that that's not the case. Alright, power's back. Like, so that you can go anywhere, so you can have both loaded with, like, you can go anywhere and it will always work. Well, I guess it's three constraints, really. You could do that. It would just be really boring. Oh, okay. It doesn't suck me in or anything.
What?
Okay. Good job, Jesus. Good job. Here you. Get out on the right side of the zero-G environment. I appreciate that, it's a nice touch. It makes sense in world as well, like, you would do that so that people don't die. Oh, fuck. I would miss. Ugh! This thing is actually overall not all that challenging. It's just imposing. Well, I say that and then I look at my health bar. There we go. We're okay. Haha, such a pushover. Hey. I'm gonna go get more health now. Were you always there? You don't do the attacky thing. I know you do. You try. That's just so gruesome. Shut up. I don't want to hear your pain. I don't trust that it's real pain. I think it's just there to lure prey. Alright. Let's move that marker. Come here, you. See, I appreciate this kind of game design as well, where, like, part of the time, yes, I'm saving the day by shooting the things, but shooting the things isn't really the thing that saves the day. Like, is this more just rogue loop thing to where it needs to be? And, that'll be that. I guess I'm actually supposed to be stasising the bridges, aren't I? But it doesn't seem to matter. Yeah. I don't know, I appreciate that. It sort of gives the thing... It gives it the feel of a wider scope. Because just shooting the things is often not really the full battle beyond. Okay. I noticed growth. More growth than before. What? Uh... that noise? Why was the music? I don't understand what just happened. If I'm honest, I really just don't understand what happened. We played some really dramatic music, and I don't know why. I didn't see anything. There was just a lot of... There were some flashing lights over there. There are still some flashing lights over there, so that seems to be a constant. I'm imagining that stuff's gonna burst through those vents at any moment. As soon as I give the first sign of weakness. What are those? Are those just trash bags? They did have a difficult problem to solve for a survival horror game with so many weapons, which is how do you keep the player armed? And I've kind of circumvented that, because I had, like I mentioned before, I had a friend who was really into Dead Space, and he did mention once to me that you should try and play with just the plasma cutter, because the game is built to give you ammo for the weapons you're carrying. And the thing to strike there is... Okay. You know, if you don't do that, then the player gets screwed, like is discouraged from using some of the weapons you're trying to give them. Because there just aren't enough resources to use them all, right? So you get a bunch of unused stuff because people feel like it's not adequate to... Like, it feels like they get screwed when they try to use it, so they just stick with the standard weapon that you balance your game around. Like, well, you know, you're always guaranteed to have this one. And it sucks. So what they... I'm pretty sure these are actually about... Because this area is really huge. So they use just like... I mean, they do it on the ship as well. When you close and open doors, it probably loads and unloads stuff. Probably keeps any, like, two linked rooms loaded, and that's it. This would be the first time that it has really big spaces, and it's loading them, you know. That wasn't there, just... What? Is that... the thing? Yeah. So... I'm gonna go collect stuff now because it's, what? That's a lot of ammo. But yeah, so you either, like, if you give people a lot of weapons and not enough resources to use all of them, they just end up using the standard weapons that you sort of guarantee that there will be. And that's kind of boring. It means that the weapons are useless. Alternatively, you just have a standard weapon, like this playthrough, where I just... Oh god. That's the same as the thing... These are the same tentacles that are on Shimura. I like how these are pushovers. Good? For some definition of good. I think we handle all of them. Don't like the cries. It's calling its brother. That is unnecessary sounds. Totally unnecessary. Now, before I move on too much... Oh, hi. That was bad on my part. Oh, okay. Did it actually reload? Okay. I think let's quit the reload animation. It does it no matter what you do, yeah. gravity tether status. Good. Looks like good. Alright. The marker looks so small, though. That thing looks so big. What? Why is this all hooked up? That was effective. That was one of the most effective approaches I've had yet. Alright. Coming? Alright. Oh. Okay, to landing pad. Sure. Now we press the button to win the game. Pieces that got kicked up as a result. What? So wait, it has like a platform.
I always believed in you. I knew you'd return to me. We are whole again, Isaac. We are whole.
We are? What?
Emergency. Geo-orbital gravity tethers offline. Tectonic load released. Impact imminent. Evacuate this area immediately.
Wait. Okay. That whole thing is just barreling down towards us now? What? Seems like a waste of time, but you know.
Isaac, you really didn't think I was just gonna walk away with you? I can't do that. Marker's coming with me.
Why do you want it so much? You know what it is.
You are insane. What? You don't believe me? Take a look at yourself. Better yet, take a look at the video from Nicole. And this time, watch it right to the end.
Yeah.
Isaac, it's me. I wish I could talk to you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry about everything. I wish I could just talk to someone. It's all falling apart here. I can't believe what's happening. Strange. Such a little thing. In the end, it all comes down to this one little thing.
What?
I didn't want it to end like this. I really wanted to see you again. Just once. I loved you. I always loved you.
What? Why? Will you explain why? Was she a unitologist? Isaac has emotions of his own.
You're insane. Just like Kai. Just like the captain. Nicole has been dead this whole time. Whatever you were seeing was caused by that. You are its pawn. But don't worry. It will be in good hands now. Far away from this damn place. Goodbye, Isaac.
So, I don't know if what she's trying to do is actually good or bad, right? Because that thing is pretty damn dangerous. And apparently just leaving it here, you know, we found it before. So maybe she has a better plan. It's unclear. She did leave me for that, so she's a bitch for that. But, you know. I will admit that I actually knew about that bit before. You know, like I said before, a friend who really likes Dead Space. That was one of the things that... It was a big twist, and it still is. Just like, she killed herself. I don't know why, though. Was it just that she didn't want to, Oh, it's entering orbit. Great. She didn't want to... get killed? By the thing? Or was it because she thought it was the future? I mean, her message didn't seem like that, because she was saying goodbye and everything. Oh, great, it's the thing inside the crater. And I know. Yep, they're loading me up. Pretty well, I might add. This is quite a bit of ammo. I don't think I've seen this many openable devices all in such close proximity to each other. How are we doing on health? Pretty good. We can afford to drop stuff that's definitely less valuable than that. Nope. Picking up the health packs. Yes. Oh, save station and everything, huh? Do I have anything to sell? Did I pick up? I thought I picked up like a ruby or something, but that might have been a little while ago. Nope. Alright, nothing to do except I'm gonna go ahead and stash. And yeah. Alternatively, I could just get nothing but large packs, because I'm pretty sure I won't have any time for anything else at this point. There's literally nothing for me to upgrade. Away! Alright. Well... Tether control, right? Maybe we can bring it back? No, not interested. Guess not. There really isn't anything I can interact with. The place has been trashed. We're crazy. Caused by the marker. Why did the marker want to be put back? Wait, what? Oh. Oh, you're here! No! Isaac? Wait,
oh.
That should probably have killed you. All that's left is her torso. We're fucked. I like it pushing around the things. Oh, weak spots! I found the weak spots! Holy hell! You know, even today, that thing is still hella impressive. I'm sorry. Oh, okay. I'm not sorry. You earned it. Being an evil bastard. Killing us all. Alright. And I see how they have some ammo drops here. Ooh, that could have been a bad thing. Ow! Oh no. Can I do anything about this? No. Okay. Don't worry about it. You're screwed. Oh boy. It's got so many teeth. That's a lot of teeth. Can we? Oh, I wasn't using aim mode. Oh no. No, don't play with your food. No, do play with your food, actually. These controls are so whack. They're actually semi-intuitive. Like, they're just mapped to the screen. Oh, that seems like it might have hurt. Come on. it looks like it hurts. Oh god. That felt like it was probably close. Alright. Good thing we have the armor. Seems like it might be essential. Did I just pick up ammo? Okay. Alright. Don't worry. Everything's terrible. Alright. Oh no! There's two! Oh, it destroyed the things. Okay. Are you gonna do the thingy? Yeah. Good. Good play. Alright. Oh, I can't hit it. So it does hit where I've been. Uh-oh. I felt like it was probably too close for comfort. Come on. Alright, we're still doing good on ammo. Keep running, Isaac. Don't stop running. Ow. Don't know why that failed. Same things I always do. Perhaps not running quite as side to side as I should have been. Alright. Side to side, Isaac. That'll be it. Oh no. Alright, just one more. Yes! We did it! Maybe. Maybe. Fine, it's okay. Why is it locked? Okay, cool. Are we leaving the marker? I don't know. That might be a bad idea. But off we go. Alright, through the atmosphere. There's the piece of chunk of rock just heading towards the planet. Oh, it loaded in. Okay. Yeah. Traveled really fast, to be honest. That's a really intense, well, space. The only place with silence. The only time we really get a look at his face, I guess. Could we control stick? No. Final cutscene, I guess. Oh boy.
Isaac,
oh, yeah?
It's me. I wish I could talk to you.
Yeah?
I'm sorry.
He was always watching it. Just take a moment. Okay. Well, that's a downer ending. Not quite a downer ending. If you saw through the you know, post effect, whatever it was. You could see that there was an Isaac just sort of holding his head while in the suit. So it's probably just him dealing with, you know, crazy times. It's interesting that both Kine and Isaac were seeing the same hallucination, because the marker wanted to be put back. But I wonder why. If so, why is it that the necromorph would still kill them? Like, they are a hive mind, right? They're being controlled by the thing on the planet. So it sounds like the thing on the planet doesn't want the marker put back? Does Kendra know that? Do we find out in Dead Space 2? I'm hoping we do. I'm gonna let the credits roll, and I'm probably just gonna talk about thoughts on the game. I mean, I will definitely say that having known about some of the things, it probably has more impact if you had gone into it blind, which, you know, you're watching this video, so either you're watching this point, you haven't played it, in which case, my recommendation is that you go it blind and don't really know anything about it, because there's some twists and the like that will, I think, have the best impact if you aren't privy to any of the behinds. Then again, it is a 7-year-old game now, so it's a little bit challenging. I totally get, especially in context, right, 2008, the whole, like, it's a zombie game where you don't shoot them in the head, that has some cool physics tech, which is still, you know, not completely impressive today, but it's at least part of the course for games today. It has a lot of smaller environments than most games, which is why they can get away with it when they did. But it still feels, it's good, it feels good, the physics scale or whatever. I probably took less advantage of it than I should have. And the time slowdown stuff as well. But they integrated it pretty well. The horror aspect, Necromorphs are, I guess, still feels a little bit, unclear to me. Maybe I missed audio logs or didn't quite piece together something. But it seems to me like they are in the marker, or they get created by the marker. I'm not sure if that's true, because I don't know how to square that with, like, why is it trying to prevent you from putting the marker back? And why the marker controls you to put it back? Why it is that it drives people crazy? I mean, I get that it's like a weapon of some... Well, they found an artifact and reproduced it, right? And it turns out to do this. And they left it alone, and then somebody else wandered to the exact right system, sort of planet cracking it, and, yeah. So the planet was an experiment. Gone wrong, and we resurfaced it. So... Yeah, I don't know what to think about. Does that actually make sense? Probably. But yeah, so overall it seems like the details on what's going on is pretty obscure. And it makes sense, right? Like, the only person who seemed to know much of anything about it was, were the Marines, I guess, at Kendra. So... makes sense that Isaac, you know, the character you're playing as, is a little bit in the dark about them. There is Dead Space 2 and 3. I did enjoy this game enough to put Dead Space 2 on my list, which I have a Steam copy of as well, so I'll probably be firing that up at some point. I want to switch over to other games for now, because I've been playing sort of like horror games for the past 3 months now, I think, as my sort of staple. So... I'll probably be going on The Witcher 3, and that will probably be another 3 months unto itself, but I'm looking forward to the change of pace. At some point, though, I'm definitely looking into Dead Space 2, because I hope it answers some of these questions. I'm going to try to go into that one blind, because I don't know a lot about that one. I know some, like, scenes from it, I'd say, but I don't know details. I don't know if we learn more about the Necromorphs or not. I don't really, I guess I didn't really talk about that with my friend who really liked Dead Space. My fat cat Nemo. Oh, yes, special tanks. We're getting near the end here. And yeah, so... I definitely really enjoyed it. I appreciate it from a horror perspective. It's not quite my speed of horror. Like, if you notice a lot of the times, like, it is very tense at times. And they do a good job of, like, making you jumpy. But it's not the tenseness that I like from things like Soma and Amnesia, where there's just this, like... I feel more genuinely afraid through those, but it's partly the disempowerment that those games offer, and partly the, not just the disempowerment, but just, like, it's, combat isn't a pillar there, right? Oh, uses havoc. Excellent. So, I like, the combat's there, and that helps you to feel a little bit powerful, whereas, you know, I don't feel as powerless, and as, I don't feel as intense. I wish I could read it. Oh, okay. Backstory logs. I'm probably going to spend some time reading those then. 10 power nodes. Impossible mode. Alright. Save your game and load it again to play another round with all of your equipment. I'm going to go ahead and drop that in. Well, no. Let's keep it sequential. Alright. That puts us right back to venue. I guess continue will just start us over. Don't really want to hit it because I don't want to. I feel like I'd be committing to something. I apologize for the noises. My headset is dying. But yeah, I'm definitely. I don't know if I'd say that I'm a really big fan, as much as some people seem to be. I definitely enjoyed it. I appreciate it. I look forward to playing through Dead Space 2. But you know, I prefer things like Amnesia. It might be a matter of taste. I haven't had enough time to like let things simmer and talked about it enough to know if I can actually try and make a judgment of like, no, there's actually like some design things and such that like, you know, let you argue that it's actually just better horror in a sense in general. I think they're just different kinds of horror for the moment. That's what I've reached. The weapons and stuff help you feel empowered, and there are sections where, if you've watched in my videos, where like the presence of enemies doesn't put fear in me. I guess they're like, there's just one enemy, I'm just like, all right, I'm gonna shoot you, wait for you, shoot you. There's some enemies that do, like even at the end there where there was that that giant dude lumbering, I was like, oh god, you guys are always such trouble. But dispatching it wasn't actually that hard, right? It's like, stay sit, smash, 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 smash. Because you have that option, you don't feel, even though you are disempowered by being an engineer and not really a military guy, you're still sort of, you're able to deal with problems, so it doesn't feel quite as desperate as something like Amnesia does. So I guess I would say that like, there's a desperation in Amnesia and Soma that doesn't quite appear. Although I guess less so and more so in Amnesia than Soma. But yeah, I've been told, many people have told me, like, you shouldn't really play Dead Space 3, or you should, but it's just an action game, so I don't know, I'll get to that once I'm done with Dead Space 2, I guess, and see how I feel about things then. Yeah, I think that's about all I've got to say. Thanks for listening to this rant as we just sit on the menu and the credits. Rant, it's not really a rant, but just rambling, I guess. So thank you for watching. I hope this has peaked, or otherwise, I don't know, I hope you are now interested in Dead Space, basically, because I know I am. And yeah, look forward to more games in the future, and as always, thank you for watching. See you next time.